Top 10 most dangerous jobs in the world. That 9-to-5 job of yours must be hectic, right? But what if I told you that some people choose to trade their life for work? These are people who know that their jobs can have fatal outcomes that sometimes can even lead to death. Hello everyone, and welcome to our channel. For today's video, we'll be looking at 10 jobs that scream danger. If you're new to our channel, don't forget to hit subscribe and like the video to get started. Every day, people go to work to earn a living, but rarely do they choose to place their lives on the line with numerous risks. No matter what the profession you belong to, whether you're flying a plane, driving a truck, working construction, or working as a chef, things can get risky from a diverse and unknown number of sources. However, some jobs are more hazardous than the rest in all ways. But how do you know the dangers of a job? Well, the danger meter of any job can be observed from their fatality rate. The Bureau of Labor Statistics determines the fatality rate of a job by analyzing the number of deaths per 100,000 full-time workers. This method ensures the correct, proper, and fair representation of all professions, regardless of the size and height of workers in the industry. In preceding years, occupations such as fisher, logger, and pilot have topped the list as the most dangerous jobs across the world. Now, with a pandemic taking over our lives, any job that takes someone out of their house feels inherently dangerous. Since the Bureau of Labor Statistics data on fatal occupational injuries and deaths is always 2 years behind, the latest numbers we have come from 2018. Now that we have all the details on how the range of danger in a job is determined, let's have a look at the list of the top 10. Number 10. People smugglers. With the ongoing proxy wars in the Middle East, we all know that the most dangerous task is to make it out alive in a war-stricken country. The Syria-Iraq war has been going on for more than a decade, which has not only resulted in the death and displacement of innocent lives, but also constant instability in the region. According to the Regional Office of Kidnapping Affairs in Kurdistan, more than 6,000 Yazidi women and children were held hostage from the Syrian-Iraq border by the terrorist organization Daesh to be sold into slavery. This human rights crisis has laid the foundation of a dangerous new industry of people smugglers who are willing to rescue the kidnapped women in exchange for up to $50,000. The sophisticated network of smugglers risk their lives, determining where a kidnapped woman is held captive before attempting a rescue mission to reunite them with their family. The industry is so thriving that from 2014 to 2016, more than half of the Yazidi prisoners have been rescued in such operations. However, the job to carry out this task is so dangerous that a failed operation can lead to every member of the network being killed. When smuggler Omar Ahmed was caught, Daesh publicly beheaded him as a warning to others. Number 9. Supervisors of construction and extraction workers. For some reason, construction and extraction supervisors are known to be more at risk than their workers. The job has a fatality rate of 21 deaths per 100,000 full-time workers, among which falls alone are responsible for half of the death toll at 134. The other foremost risk factor for this job is being hit by a falling or swinging object. Some other professions that are similar to this category include electricians, construction equipment operators, carpenters, and building inspectors. All of them are at the risk of severe injuries. While we mention severity, extraction workers, especially at mines, are more likely to face injuries or, in some cases, death. A similar case of rat hole mining can be looked into to demonstrate the risks of this job. An estimated 70,000 children risk their lives daily to mine coal in the Jhentia Hills in India. The trafficked children scamper through the narrow webs of the deep underground mines without any safety equipment to chip away coal with their pickaxes. The mines don't have any maintenance, and accidents are common because the shafts are prone to collapsing. This increases the risks of workers being in danger, trapped, or killed during cave-ins. Between 2007 and 2014, 10 to 15,000 people, including children, were thought to have died after being trapped in collapsed rat holes in the Jhentia Hills. Number 8. Structural iron and steel workers. Working with iron, massive steel beams, and heavy cranes all day is no doubt hazardous. This might come as a surprise that even though the materials they work with are heavy and enormous, most of the 23.6 deaths per 100,000 workers are due to falling or slipping accidents. Despite the apparent risks in this industry, there's no sign of its appeal hindering new workers, since it shows an anticipated 11% growth projection from 2018 to 2028. as reported by the Bureau of Labor Statistics. Heights, swimming objects, steel beams, collapsing walls, and electrical lines are some of the few elements that make this profession somewhat risky and hazardous to human life. Steel and structural iron workers rank as the eighth most dangerous job globally, with an estimated 27 fatalities out of 100,000 workers. While falls are the major cause of death in this occupation, burns, muscle strains, cuts, and broken limbs are accountable for most injuries. Number 7. Oil field workers. Nobody would have imagined that oil riggers can face such high risks while at their place of work. However, the Deepwater Horizon explosion and oil spill that occurred in 2010 in the Gulf of Mexico will forever remind the world of 11 oil workers who lost their lives on the spot. This tragic accident made it well known that oil rigging, although a well-paying job, is also a dangerous job both onshore and offshore. Some things that expose these workers to risk include heavy equipment, heights, and a lot of dangerous materials. The most amazing part is that the most significant cause of death for extraction and oil laborers happens to be vehicle crashes. In addition to that, fatigue and long, unsafe travels on assorted rigs are the primary reasons why these accidents occur. Number 6. Truck drivers, sales workers, and other drivers. Now, you might be thinking, what's the danger in driving? But this profession being 6th on the list of most dangerous jobs is no joke. Every driver's daily commute is filled with tension related to traffic, frustration, and danger. The risks increase exponentially for workers whose job is to drive all day long. Driving all day might seem easy, but imagine yourself being on the road for that long without any breaks. Truck drivers and other driving professionals experience a 26 fatality work injury rate, making these the 6th most dangerous occupations of 2020. But that's just one aspect of it. Among drivers, there are some who drive on roads where shooting and possibly getting killed are not uncommon. Take an example of a Syrian bus driver. In 2015, the British newspaper The Telegraph asked if being a driver in Syria is the riskiest job in the world. Bus drivers in Syria are at constant risk of robbery, kidnapping, and live ammunition as they gear through the front lines of both Daesh jihadists and Assad regime forces. All the drivers must have beards to prove their Islamic faith to be granted access to drive through jihadist-controlled areas. But that doesn't stop the risk of them being caught in the crossfire or shot in the head by a sniper. Number 5. Farmers, ranchers, and agricultural managers. While you might be thinking why some people would risk their lives for work, we all know that many potentially dangerous industries are vital to everyone. Such is agriculture, fishers, and ranchers. It's essential to keep in mind that ranchers, farmers, and agricultural workers face risks every day. Even with the technological advances in the previous decades, farmers and ranchers still have to work with heavy equipment and machinery in extreme or uncooperative weather conditions. They also work with various mechanical vehicles, such as tractors and lawnmowers. These motorized vehicles are the main culprit in the 24.7 fatality work rate for these professionals, making it 5th on the most dangerous jobs of 2020. On the other hand, several people who don't work in the commercial fishing industry imagine that fishing is all about long, relaxing days on the beautiful water and occasionally clearing out a full net. However, this vital industry is far from relaxing nowadays, as commercial fisheries have a fatality rate of 77.4 deaths per 100,000 workers. The reason for deaths can usually be attributed to drowning, extreme weather conditions, impacts, and shipwrecks, falls on slippery decks, or malfunctioning gear. However, there are other factors involved. The most recent records from the Bureau of Labor Statistics made it known that fishers face a lot of unexpected and unplanned occurrences on the open waters. Because they're far away from medical aid, they get to gamble with their lives. A slight miscalculation can lead to grief. Just as you'd expect, the highest cause of death in this occupation is drowning. Fishers and all other sea-related workers are the most dangerous amongst those in the list of occupations. Number 4. Roofers. Did you ever think of what those roofers do at the top of your house? These people expose themselves to the risks of falling off your roof by walking around the top of your office building and homes. So it isn't much of a surprise that roofing is high on the list of hazardous jobs, since these jobs include climbing ladders and walking around on steep roofs all day. They have to be cautious, watch their balance, and watch out for fellow workers, since falls from roofs cause 1/3 of the industry deaths. The fatality rate for this profession is 51.5 per 100,000, with more than 100 fatalities each year. As suspected, Falling is the reason behind most of these deaths. Injuries and illness are also common in roofing due to the materials they use and the weather they face. Number 3. Underwater welders. Water and electricity are opposite entities that are not meant to be working together or worked on together. However, it's just another aspect of the job of underwater welders. These specialists repair ships, dams, pipelines, and many other things while exposing themselves to many hazards and dangers, including different pressure hazards and explosions. Something to look out for is when a diver is stuck under extreme high pressure of flowing water. At this point, they're at the risk of drowning. Although the Bureau of Labor Statistics cannot come up with an exact death rate for those in this occupation, other sources asserted that underwater welders' death rate is about 40 times higher than that of the average worker. Number 2. Trash and recycling collectors. At number 2 stands trash and recycling collectors, who have among the most dangerous jobs in the entire world. Many people may not consider refuse and recycling collection a dangerous job, but workers put their lives on the line each time they clear residence containers. The average salary of a waste collector is about $40,000 annually, but some can make $100,000 or more, usually based on how well they work. This pay is earned by taking out dirt and waste in the street and placing their own lives on the line with the risk of hazardous diseases by handling lethal waste and discharges. Its fatality rate comes in at 44.3 per 100,000, and most of these are caused by either the worker or the truck getting struck by another vehicle when trying to pass without slowing down. Referencing the most recent data from the Bureau of Labor Statistics, not less than 40 deaths are recorded every year, with most deaths taking place by falling off trucks, accidents with machines, or getting a disease from working with waste. The worst-case scenario and severity of this job can be demonstrated from the 10,000-square-meter mound of rotting rubbish on Jakarta's Indonesian island, which provides 24 hours of available work for the 2,000 scavengers that live and work at the site. Scavengers as young as 5 search the dump for materials that can be then sold to recycling companies, as well as food for their dinners. 10 people reportedly died on the garbage heap after being hit by a digger. Not only that, but by working and living in the landfill, most scavengers are at constant risk of tuberculosis and ringworms. Number 1. Lumberjacks and landscapers. Finishing off the top 10 dangerous jobs of 2020 are lumberjacks, tree service workers, and gardeners. The only thing scarier than bringing down a heavy and tall tree is operating the machine used in making this task possible. It may appear simple enough, but these workers are regularly exposed to heights and sharp tools. The job hazard is visible when one has to control and operate the machine while they're suspended in the air for a couple of minutes or maybe even hours. In 2016, the Bureau of Labor Statistics reported that log workers have the highest rates of death. With the average death count being 136 deaths out of 100,000 workers, this is the world's most dangerous job. Most of these injuries stem from contact with machinery like heavy-duty power tools or being struck by a log or a falling tree. Industry experts are experimenting with new ways to make this job safer, such as instituting safety measures and requiring safety equipment such as hard hats. To put it all in perspective, even though this is the last job on the list, it's still 5 times higher than the average work fatality rate. If this list of hazardous jobs made you love your work, then don't forget to hit the thumbs up on the video. Make sure you comment down below on your thoughts and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and watch other videos. Until the next video, stay curious and goodbye.